And I was talking to David Beckham at the time, and I just was like, sorry, David, one second. Hey, I'm Emery, and this is my teenage self. Okay, first question. Was there anything you used to do as a teenager that you really miss? There are some things that I was like that I've definitely grown out of. And I think that just generally happens when you get older. You just like, you think you have to grow up and be mature and make all these decisions and life gets hard and all this stuff. And you forget to have fun and you forget to see stuff with your younger eyes, I think. So a lot of things just become a bit like daunting instead of fun. And like the fun gets taken out of a lot of things. So I think even with making music and going out and with my friends and organising stuff, I'm trying to be my younger self again, just to remember the fun that you can have just within your home, and you don't have to go out all the time and stuff like that. It's just playing games and stuff like that. What would you tell your younger self? Get a grip. I swear. I feel like when I was younger, I had kept a lot of things inside because of pure embarrassment or like worried about what people will think or whatever. And if only I said something and someone could just say to me, get a grip, like everything's gonna be all right. Just stop worrying about it and have fun, move on, you know. This is just a phase. You're gonna get out of it and things are gonna get easier. If I had just said to someone how I was feeling and they said that to me, I think my life would have been really different when I was a teenager. But I didn't. I kept it all in and I kept the worrying and the embarrassment and all the stuff that I felt, and it just hindered me quite a lot and gave me a lot of anxiety. And it isn't till recently where I've had to unfold all of that, which I could have done when I was younger if I'd actually said something. But yeah, I would definitely love to say to myself, get a grip, everything's gonna be all right. Just chill out. What was your favorite song growing up? I've got so many of so many different genres. I think one was Alanis Morissette, Ironic. That was one of my favorites. Lauryn Hill, Zion was one of my favorites. Eminem, a lot of Eminem songs. There's also like Baby Cakes by Three of a Kind, that's chucked in there. There's so many different songs. What was your most awkward teenage dating moment? I mean, I feel like I was such a loner when I was a teenager, I actually didn't even go near anyone. Yeah, no, it's all right, I'm fine with it. I think when I was like really young in school, we used to just switch boyfriends all the time. So like we'd just, yeah, like we'd go in the playground and then some boy would come up to me and be like, you're dumped, I'm going out of her now. And I'd be like, all right, well, Lewis, do you want to go out now? So I just go out of it. So it's very much, you know, like fun, but nothing really embarrassing really. I guess I was just a bit of a crazy chick, so yeah, I didn't really hold on to boyfriends that long. Yeah, even though we just did that when we were younger, my mum and dad have been with each other since they were 14. So my whole goal of being with someone was like, this is who I'm gonna be with forever, from like young. So I've always been that obsessive, weird girlfriend that's like, we're gonna get married and we're gonna have kids. And I, now. And yeah, that didn't work out. So I've always been a bit weird with dating. I've always been like, this is marriage, not dating, all right? And people ain't really into that for some reason. What was your signature scent growing up? I don't really wear scent anymore, but when I was a teenager, it was La Vie Esbelle. And I don't know if you smell that, but it's really sweet. Cause I just like everything sweet. Everything has to taste sweet and be sweet. And yeah, that was my smell. And I used to work in House of Fraser in Lakeside Shopping Center. And every time I'd walk past it, I'd just like spray myself with it quickly so I didn't have to buy a new one. Le Com. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah. Maybe if they watch this. Yeah. What TV show, movie was your teenage self obsessed with? So growing up and still now, I'm obsessed with Jim Carrey movies. So I watch Liar Liar, Bruce Almighty all the time. And also it was Simpsons. I used to watch The Simpsons all the time. And this also this like weird little thing that used to come on after stuff, which was like 3 minutes long, and it was called Angry Kid. And I don't know if you've seen that, but it's the funniest thing ever. So Angry Kid, Simpsons, well, EastEnders, I used to binge watch all the time as well, and Neighbours. Oh God, I love TV. I can't act, right? Which is really annoying to me, because I'd love to be able to act. I'm like, I can sing, I can dance a little bit, but acting, it just makes me cringe so much. I did acting at, or like musical theatre at college, and because it's drama, singing, and dance, and every time we did a drama piece, I was just cringing so much, and I found it so hard to become someone else. I think it's because when I was a teenager, I tried to fit in so much that I never really was myself. So the older I got, I was like, I can't not be myself anymore. So when I try and act like someone else, it just gives me this fear of not being authentic. So actors, I feel like they love the idea of becoming a different person in this thing. And I'm just like, I can't think of anything worse. But I'd love to do a movie, but just be like the stunt double for someone who's having a fight. Because I do karate, so I'd love to be the stunt double for a movie like that. I'd love that. Who was your celebrity crush as a teenager, and have you met them since? Well, I love Nelly. Nelly was my crush. Weirdly, Joe Cole was my crush as well from West Ham. John Mayer, I guess. But I think I haven't met them. I've seen John Mayer walk past me, and that I froze. And I was talking to David Beckham at the time, and I just was like, sorry, David, 1 second. So yeah, that was kind of crazy. But no, I haven't met them, and I don't want to. No, I'm not saying hello. I'd be a weirdo. I'll be like, marriage, kids. No. What embarrassing teenage trends did you take part in? Everyone possible, really. I feel like when the thin eyebrows came about, I plucked my eyebrows till they were so thin. And now it's not embarrassing really, because it's fashionable. So kind of got not embarrassing anymore. But fake tan, that was one I did a lot, and now I don't do anymore. Leg warmers, that was cringe. Oh God. But I guess still coming back a little bit, I guess. One thing I used to wear all the time was that really massive chunky belt that was like circles, and you could like put it wherever you want because it would just slot into one of the discs. That was quite embarrassing. That basically fashion was really embarrassing for me when I was a teenager, because I just wanted to be different so much that everything I wore was disgusting. Like I would just go to the extreme of looking disgusting just for the fact of being different. I remember going to, whenever I used to go out to parties or clubs or whatever, I'd actually take another outfit in my bag just in case someone was wearing the same outfit as me. I don't know what it was. I think just like being a teenager and trying to fit in and being so impressionable and worrying what people thought so much, I just didn't know who I was. And then as I've grown up and learned to love myself, who I am, and a lot of therapy and all that stuff, I think the worst thing I could think of in my life is to conform to anything and like dress a certain way to be accepted or behave a certain way to be liked. I think all of those things just give me the ick so bad, and it's just like almost the most opposite extreme of doing anything I can to not fit in. It's just like my life. So yeah, I'm quite chaotic and annoying, but whatever. Which artists or bands did you have on your wall growing up? I think I had Christina Aguilera and Britney Spears. But then when I got a little bit older, it was like The Streets and more left bands like Grizzly Bear and Enter Shikari, and I was going like really left. And then I was like trying to be really cool, and then I realised how much I love Britney Spears still, so she came back. But yeah, I've loved every music really. My mum and dad, I grew up listening to like Paul Weller and ska music and stuff like that because of my mum and dad, so a bit of everything going on in my head, if you can't tell from my own music, which is all over the place. What did you want to be when you were a teenager? I mean, I did karate, so I wanted to be a karate instructor and have my own karate club. And then I wanted to be a private detective. So that was like my dream job and still is my dream job. So maybe in the future, after this, I'll be finding you. So don't do anything bad. Thank you for watching me delve into my embarrassing teenage self. Check out my new song, Unhealthy, with Shania Twain right now. It's out.